Casey Betts has been aboard twice. Max Muncy, excuse me, Kike Hernandez has been aboard twice and scored twice. Despite all that, they're still down by five because the Mets absolutely battered Jack Flaherty for three innings.
And for the Dodgers, they've had plenty of opportunities. Again, we talked about first four innings. They stranded eight runners.
First pitch, Brandon Nimmo swings and slices it in the air. Foul ground, third base side. Muncy drifts over. On the very edge of the grass, he makes the catch. One pitch, one out for Brent Honeywell in the fifth.
Steve, I think the is your philosophy really right now at the Dodgers has to be, look, if we can put up some goose eggs on the board against the Mets, they've just pounded the ball all night the first four innings. Uh-huh. This game is still not out of hand. Though they missed some opportunities. That first inning we talked about left the bases loaded in the fourth inning.
Argentos the batter. One out, nobody on. First pitch from Honeywell. Harrell's inside, ball one. Problem is, goose eggs have been nearly impossible to come by for the Dodgers. I mean, the four innings at the plate, the Mets have scored three of them.
Well, yeah, they have swung the bat exceptionally well tonight. They had some good pitches, they have too.
Pitch. Argentos pops it up, shallow center. Kike drifts back from second. Pajes charging in from center field. He calls Kike off and makes the catch.
Well, your Dodgers, yep, they're in the postseason again, and now's your chance to experience the thrill of October Baseball Live. So secure your postseason tickets at Dodgers.com/postseason.
Pete Alonso, he really set the tone. I think you could say that for New York tonight. Three-run home run off Jack Flaherty in the bottom of the first inning. 3-0 New York lead. Off the hop, crowd into it. PK. Max Muncy at third. What a play at third by Max Muncy. A hard hit ground ball to Muncy's left. Hit the deck, spun around, and fired a strike to Freddie Freeman. Quick inning from Brent Honeywell. Retiring the Mets in order. All right, Mo. A 1-2-3 pitch inning. Let's go to the sixth. Still 10-5 New York.
This is AM 570 LA Sports.
In the history of Dodger Stadium, there have been 19 total rainouts. Hi, I'm Dave Roberts, and last year's rain was one for the books, and it was L.A. County's best for capturing that rain. Over 200 billion gallons of storm water was captured, enough for 5 million people, or enough water to cover attendance at 89 sold-out home games. L.A. County worked hard to ensure a safe, clean, reliable water future. Find out more at waterforla.com.
Hi, it's Hannah, and welcome to The Handicap. Today, Piggy Bank is going to fuel our episode with questions about ARCO rewards. Yep, earn up to $7 in rewards to sign up. Uh-huh, and 5 cents on every gallon. Sounds pretty sensible, if you ask me. Oh, all the savings talk making you hungry? Here you go. Learn how to earn at ARCOrewards.com.
October 1st, 2024. Claim on the phone number. Your claim receive a current automated informational marketing SMS and MMS messages from Marathon. Other terms and conditions may apply. Purchase trading locations only.
Grammy award-winning country music stars will take the Yonkova Theater stage this fall. Country pop duo Dan and Shay bring their Heartbreak on the Met tour on September 7th. Sam Hunt returns on October 24th. Plus, country icons Brooks and Dunn perform November 9th. Tickets on sale now at YonkovaTheater.com. Don't miss Dan and Shay, September 7th. Sam Hunt, October 24th. And Brooks and Dunn, November 9th. Live at Yonkova Resort and Casino at San Manuel, California's number one entertainment destination. Must be 21 or under.
The fifth inning was presented by Yamava Resort and Casino at San Manuel. San Manuel is now Yamava Resort and Casino at San Manuel. Find out more at Yamava.com.
Dodgers trailing Mets 10-5. Top of the sixth on tap. It'll be Betts, Hernandez, and Freeman against Ryan Stanek. Hard throwing big right-handed reliever. Really broke out a couple years ago when he was with the Astros. Dominant in 2022. Fell off last season in what was his walk year. Signed with the Mariners, then was traded to the Mets ahead of the deadline. Mookie, 1-for-2, a double and a walk. And popped out to Alonso, sandwiched in between those plate appearances. Starting the sixth, trying to chip further away at this big New York lead. It was 10-2, but a three-run home run from Pajes in the fifth I just have a little life. Mookie with a swing and a foul ball. 97 on a fastball right down the middle. That's the kind of pitch you want to do damage against when you have Stanek on the mound.
Well, now Team Song is base runners.
Stanek. Green first base out of the mound. Mookie Betts hits a hard left field, pushing Nimmo back, and he turns around, and Mookie Betts with a bomb! A leadoff home run for Mookie in the sixth, and the Dodgers are within four.
Well, you start to look back at the opportunities that were squandered, including back in the first inning. For some reason, Ohtani did not take off from third with the infield back. That cost a run. And all the runners have been left on base, but they keep closing the gap. And with that trip around the diamond, you stop by Daniel's Jewelers. They're going to be busy. Just pay home runs for your free team bracelet and a $50 gift card towards any purchase of $99 or more. Daniel's Jewelers, own the dream.
Teoscar Hernandez swings and misses strike one. But Mookie Betts with his fourth home run of the postseason, second in as many nights. Third home run of the game for the Dodgers. It's now 10-6. The pitch. The Oscar takes ball one down and in. Fastball at 97 just missed inside.
The Dodgers get back on track. This game's not out of hand. They've got to close the door against the Mets offensively, however.
The pitch. Hernandez waves at strike two. Goodness gracious. It's like there's a hole in the bat for tail right now, Mo.
The swing's getting really big, really long, and he's having trouble catching up with. Not even upper echelon fastballs. I mean, just the mediocre fastballs. And then, we've talked so many times, his vulnerability has been sliders away.
Behind one and two. Stanek comes home. Off the plate away. Two and two.
99.
Velocity has never been the issue for Stanek.
Nope.
2-2 pitch. Hernandez strikes out swinging. 98 on the 14 fastball to me. Second K of the night for Teoscar, who remains hitless in the National League Championship Series. A stunning LCS for one of the Dodgers' MVPs this year. He is lost. That's the first out for Stanek in the sixth. Here's Freddie Freeman. First pitch swinging and missing, strike one. Mookie led off the sixth with a home run. So it's 10-6, Dodgers. As they stay in Queens, you got to believe. I know they're talking about their Mets, but if you're a Dodger fan, do you believe? Freddie swings and misses again, quickly 0-2. And it peers in. At the belly button, now the 0-2 pitch is high. Vince Stanek, Freddie Freeman, 2-for-6 with two walks. Those two hits, both home runs. But Freddie, not close to 100%. And Stanek, second out, just pumped 97 by him. And Freddie, obviously not right. His second strike out of the game. Back-to-back case for Stanek, two going in the sixth. Eight punch-outs in the game for the Dodgers. That's just another aspect of the role reversal, the flipping of the script that we've discussed several times already tonight. These two teams after the last two nights. Tommy Edman holds off on a high fastball, 1-0. Mets 10, Dodgers 6. L.A. has scored in three consecutive innings. 4-0. Edmund swings. It's a fly ball to center field. No problems for Taylor. He's waiting on it. Makes the catch. Master glove coming off the mound. Walking across the chalk. The inning started positively for the Dodgers. Mookie Betts turned on a fastball from Ryan Stanek and sent it out to left field in a hurry. A solo shot cuts into the deficit. It's now 10-6, New York.
The exclusive home of the Dodgers. AM 570, LA Sports. Medi-Cal renewals are happening now. All members' eligibility is reviewed once annually, and everyone's renewal date is different. You can check your renewal month in your online BenefitsCal.com account. If your current address, email, or phone number have changed, please update your information with your local county office. If you get a renewal form in the mail in a yellow envelope, you must complete it to keep your Medi-Cal. If you don't, you will lose your coverage. Visit LACARE.org for more information. That's LACARE.org.
Today's the day for a new Tacoma or Tundra. For a new Corolla or the all-new Camry. For a new Prius or a new RAV4. Yeah, today is the day for a great deal on Toyota's most popular models. Fuel-efficient cars, powerful trucks, versatile SUVs. Check out the latest offers at Toyota.com. Then, be your Toyota dealer today. We make it easy. Toyota, let's get closer.
Toyota.com is Toyota's central for all things Toyota. At Toyota.com, you can get product information, compare models, check out all the latest offers, find a dealer, search our inventory, set up a test drive. You can even build your Toyota the way you want. The road to a great deal on a new Toyota starts at Toyota.com.
We make it easy on you.
Toyota, let's go places.
This is the home of L.A. Dodgers baseball.
What a night!
Hear the blue all season long right here.
The home of the Dodgers.
Dodgers smile a little bit closer thanks to Mookie Betts' solo home run. It's 10-6 New York, bottom of the sixth inning. Well, the other aspect of this, more goose eggs aren't necessary.
Yeah, you have to be able to close the door as far as the other side, because you've got a still a sizable gap down by four. But if the Dodgers go into the mode that we have seen, you know, they're capable of doing it, but they got to start bringing some good at-bats together. Get runners on. This isn't about hitting a ball out of the ballpark right now. It's getting runners on and keep the line moving.
Hurry into your Southern California Chevy dealers today and find a great offer on your next vehicle. Go to SoCalChevy.com for more information. Brent Honeywell needed just four pitches to get through the fifth. And on to the sixth, it's Winker Marte Taylor, 567. First hit. Ball one to the next DH. Back in the starting lineup. Sat the last two nights in favor of J.D. Martinez. It had Met fans up in arms. Comes back in. He has a walk and an RBI triple. He's in front. Two balls, no strikes. There's also scored twice. Going home on a sack fly from McNeil. Then a foul ball back. 2-1. Big swing, big miss. 94 fastball up and in. Good pitch from Brent Honeywell Jr. With a big arms left in the bullpen for New York, unless they try and run Stanek out there again, the only high leverage one yet left is Edwin Diaz. Also with another swing and a foul ball. Count remains 2-2. They have Phil Maton, who pitched last night. Maton goes through 29 pitches. Not a high velo guy, and someone that they have run out there, especially down the stretch, in consecutive days for heavy workloads. Here's a 2-2. And that got the foot of Jesse Winker. It's the third batter that Honeywell has hit, and it comes with two strikes. Just tough. Lead off batter on in the sixth inning.
He's not been automatic when he's taken the mound either.
But the Dodgers have to put up more zeros to make sure that they get within striking distance.
They're not going to get there in if you're hitting batters.
The two strikes especially. Now Marte. First hit Peter off the plate but called strike one. Honeywell take the gift. And Bill Miller behind home plate. Marte's 2-for-3, two doubles, two RBIs, and a run scored. He's batting 275 in this postseason. The pitch. Swing, line, into the left center field gap. It'll get down. Hernandez just cuts it off. Swings and fires, but Marte is going to have another double and make it second and third. This is the problem. And you put the leadoff batter on by hitting him, just like they did Alonso in the fourth inning. And now it's second and third, nobody out. You just got to within four. But Dave Roberts and the Dodgers opting to keep Brent Honeywell Jr. in there.
Throwing in the bullpen.
Nope. And look, on the heels of a four-pitch inning, I understand. And you're trying to stay away from a higher leverage guy.
Well, in the sixth inning, a four-run game is doable.
Two in scoring position, no out. I'm in favor of the batter. Thorne's native at the infield zone in. Honeywell misses down and away, ball one. It would be a backbreaker.
Well, in this series, the Mets came into tonight with 29 at-bats with runners in scoring position, only four hits. Well, this is their 15th at-bat tonight with a runner in scoring position.
Darlin Marte, third double tonight, second and third. Taylor swings, popped up, shallow center field. Paez charging, and he's there in right center to make the catch. No runners can move. Jeff McNeil, who had a sack fly his last time up, but he didn't miss a three-run home run by much.
Not at all. Well, for Trent Honeywell, the first pitcher with three hit batters in a postseason game since Lance McCullers Jr. hit four in 2017, game seven against the Dodgers.
Infield stays in. Second and third, one out. McNeil swings and misses. Strike one. McNeil fractured his wrist the first week of September. Didn't know if his season would be over because of this stunning, lengthy postseason run for the Mets. He's activated for the LCS. 0-3 is a pinch hitter at his first start tonight. 0-1. Fouled back. Two strikes.
Back-to-back games right before Jimmy Cole being activated. Seven innings in both of those contests.
Second and third, one out. Mets 10, Dodgers 6. Honeywell's 0-2 pitch to McNeil. One on poke foul on the left side. It's over the net. Beyond the Dodger dugout.
McNeil is one of those hand-back coordination guys that, slaps, gets the ball over the plate,
poked up.
Yep. And you look at his bat, you have a difficult time determining which end is the barrel, which end is the handle. There's no knob on his bat, and it's a very thick handle bat.
And Duke still in. And tipped it over to the right side. Another 0-2 pitch. McNeil drives it to center field. Paez is waiting, setting up. He makes the catch. Winker tagging from third. Here's the throw home. It is high and late. Another sacrifice fly from McNeil. And that turned this game up to 11. So it's 11-6.
That's why McNeil is in there. He's a contact guy.
So hitting the leadoff man with two strikes. Bites. Honeywell on the Dodgers, and they give Mookie Betts home run right back. Now Marte's on third. Two down for Francisco Alvarez, the catcher in the number nine hitter. Just a wildly frustrating night for the Dodger pitchers. Jack Flaherty and Brent Honeywell.
Well, if you think the pitchers are frustrated, ask the outfield now. They've been chasing mistakes down all night.
The pitch. Alvarez swings and misses, nothing to one. Alvarez came into this game 2-for-10 in the series with four strikeouts. He is 3-for-3. So as many hits tonight as he had the first four games combined, or more than he had the first four games combined. Excuse me. Marte on third, two out. Dodger infield back. 3-0-1. Hit in the air, right field. Mookie Betts on the run. It is slicing towards the foul pole, and it drifts foul. Did not have the distance for a home run.
That's a long second strike. Larry Martinez enjoyed it. They've gone to the record books. Wayne McDonald found it. Marte, the first Mets player ever with three doubles in a postseason game.
Taking time, Alvarez steps back in, batting from the right side. O'Neill has two strikes on him. The pitch. Fouled over the screen behind home plate. Alvarez stays alive. So, came around and got him on the follow through. Checks on Will Smith, his fellow catcher. So, sorry about that. Will gets down into the crowd. Still 0-2. Dodgers trailing by five once again. Another 0-2 pitch. On the ground to short. Picked up by Edmund. Throws across. Alvarez retired. But a second sacrifice fly from McNeil tonight. And that's get one right back. So it's 11-6. Game five. Going to the seventh.
AM 570.
LA's Best Sports Talk. The real home of the Dodgers.
It's playoff time, baseball fans. This is Jorge Jaramillo, and I want you to know that I'm bringing someone special into the lineup to help me reach the finish line this season. Chef Marico's Chicken Seasoning. It's a true utility player who helps me excel at every level in the kitchen. Whether it's chicken fajitas, enchiladas, even roasted chicken, I know it'll be a hit when Chef Marico steps up to my plate. With Chef Marico Seasoning, the chef is in you. Available at your local grocery store or chefmarico.com.
What key is tonight going to be played in? Well, that's entirely up to you and your spirit. Over here at Wild Turkey, we're opting for something that rings true and can reverberate for ages. A little 101. Wild Turkey 101 has been pleasing crowds for decades with its iconic rich flavor. Crafted with generations of know-how and the finest ingredients. Wild Turkey. Trust your spirit.
Copyright 2024, Campari America, New York, New York. Never compromise. Drink responsibly.
City of Hope. We're more than just a top-ranked cancer hospital. For over 100 years, we've been making breakthroughs, pushing the limits of what's possible, targeting cancer at the molecular level, pioneering treatments used worldwide. At City of Hope, your entire cancer-fighting team is bound together by a single mission, to cure your cancer. And now City of Hope is closer than ever, providing the cancer care all patients deserve. Learn more at cityofhope.org.
The L.A. Dodgers are back. Back to the field for more L.A. Dodgers baseball. And now we return to the Galvin Motors broadcast booth.
Dodger fans, the seventh inning is brought to you by Safety Pizza Parlor. Celebrating 70 years of pizza, chicken, and mojos. Order yours now at safety.com. Alongside Rick Monday, with producer and engineer Dwayne McDonald, Stephen Nelson, happy to have you back with us at Citi Field, despite what has happened up to this point at Citi Field. Dodgers trailing game five, 11-6. That was in 10-6, thanks to Mookie Betts' home run. But then, Trent Honeywell hit Jesse Winker. Marte doubled him for third, and then he came home to score on a sacrifice fly. The deficit is five. DJ Hernandez leads off the seventh inning.
So when you think you have it all dialed in and figured out, again, the Dodgers have outscored the Mets first four games, 30-9. That's 21 run differential. The highest differential in baseball history through four postseason games.
Ryan Stanek back out there. First pitch, yanked the fastball away from Kike Hernandez. Ball one. The Dodgers offense, the sixth inning or later this series, batting .284 with seven extra base hits, five home runs. They've scored 17 runs with 15 walks and hit by pitch. So they need that late inning offensive magic once again. Stanek gets strike one to even the count. The pitch way outside. Gets by Alvarez and all the way to the backstop.
Well, it also looks, Stephen, as if Dave Roberts has decided, or the Dodgers have decided, look, we're going to take our lumps tonight, and they're trying to save the bullpen. The Honeywell in there, he's hit three. He's given up three.
pitch, PK turns and lifts a fly ball to shallow left. Lindor backing up from short makes the catch. On number one in the seventh inning. Here's Max Muncy. Swing and a foul ball back, straight back into the net. It ricochets halfway between the home plate and the mound, in fact.
And there's a couple of right-handers throwing right now in their bullpen.
Dank misses. One ball, one strike. Next 11, Dodgers 6. Base is empty, one gone, top of the seventh. Danek with his 25th pitch of the night. Muncy hits it high in the air, foul territory. First base side, Alvarez, the catcher, and Alonzo will watch it drift into the seat.
Well, it's not early about Edwin Diaz. He's one of the two. Phil Maton is the other one, getting ready in the cement bullpen. Diaz has not thrown for a number of days, and they need to get him in there at some point in this game.
There's a big overhang in front of our booth, so any ball that's hit in the air here at City Field, you really don't have an idea of where it's going. But the way that the Mets infield drifted over there, it looked like, oh, they may have a chance to make a play, but that was pretty deceit. And a 1-2 pitch. Muncy strikes out swinging.
As Panic slipped and fell down in the foul for making that pitch.
And he signals to the dugout. He's okay. His infielders are walking toward him as well. Got the first two outs of the seventh. Wow. The Dodgers are pinch hitting for Will Smith. It's Gavin Lux.
Andrew Smith out of there, let him cool his heels, and get Austin Barnes in there behind the plate. Finish out the game.
Here's the pitch. Lux checks up on a fastball upstairs at 98, 1-0. Lux pinch hitting for Smith here with two outs and nobody on in the seventh. Santa comes back. The fastball at 96 on the other third to level the count.
Well, you know, you figure, okay, let's throw the lefty up there. The guy on deck, Páez, is 3-for-3 with two home runs.
The pitch. Rush swings three, strike two. But the way Will Smith has been swinging the bat, and it's been not swinging the bat. Sort of understand, that's a mile with the scoreboard. This is 0-for-3 tonight. 3-for-19 in the series. 1-2 pitch on the way. Gavin Lux swings and hits it high in the air. Pops up on the infield. McNeil waving everybody off at second base. The 1-2-3-7 for Ryan Stanek. 11-6 New York. Let's go.
LA's best sports talk.
That's a good endorsement there.
AM570 LA Sports.
Medicare beneficiaries need help choosing the right health plan during this year's AEP? Let PIH Health be your guide to all things enrollment. Don't miss your chance to join our network in 2025. Visit PIHHealth.org/Medicare or call 888-365-4450. That's 888-365-4450. 888-365-4450. PIH Health, your health and wellness partner.
I like choices. We all like choices. So when you're choosing a vehicle, your Southern California Ford dealer is a great place to start. Whether you choose one of the best-selling Ford F-150s, a Mustang Mach-E, or a Ford Bronco, there's a gas, hybrid, or all-electric vehicle of your choice. But more important than the type of power you choose is what you choose to do with it. So go to your Southern California Ford dealer today and tell them ED session.
Fall means playoff baseball in SoCal, and just like our boys in blue need to play at their best, your car or truck need to be running at its best. The only place to go is Valvoline Instant Oil Change, home of the 15-minute drive-through oil change. Find a Valvoline Instant Oil Change near you at SoCalOilChange.com.
Feed your need for fun at Harrah's Resort SoCal and the world's largest Hell's Kitchen restaurant. From wine pairing to preparing a classic beef Wellington, learn to entertain like Chef Gordon Ramsay. To learn more or plan a stellar stay, visit HarrahsSoCal.com.
Now, this very moment, back to the Gelson Motors broadcast booth on your official home of Los Angeles Dodgers baseball.
Austin Barnes now behind home plate. The bottom of the seventh inning, the Dodgers trail game 5-5, 11-6 New York. Dodgers were in a hole from Jump Street. 3-0 after one. 3-1 going to the third. The Mets scored 5 runs, 10-9 to the plate against Jack Flaherty. He started with 8 runs in just 3 innings of work. The Dodgers got 3 in the fifth, 1 in the sixth. Make it 10-4 for 2. 10-6 after the half. The Mets scored their last half inning. So they lead by a handful. Now at the top of the order at the plate. Honeywell still pitching. His first one to Lindor. Airs away. Ball one. Anthony fans are as much of the bullpen as possible. Lindor is 2-for-4 tonight. That's a pitch from Honeywell. And it's a fastball 92, but outside. 2-0. The Dodgers are going to leave it up to their offense. There to come back in this one. 2-0 pitch. 3 balls, no strike. Just every time it looked like the Dodgers are going to give their pitchers some help. 3-0. 4 pitch walk to open the 7. And the fourth inning of work for Honeywell to start, and put the leadoff man on in 3 of them.
No one moving in the Dodgers bullpen.
Brandon Nimmo with Lindor dancing. The pickoff attempt, gonna get him. Lindor was trying to mess with Honeywell. And Honeywell turned and fired to Freddie Freeman, who put the tag on the Mets leader. And just like that, the base is once again clear.
Yeah,
that was very odd and unnecessary with
him. Yeah, Lindor was playing around, and he got played.
Yikes. That's just brutal from the MVP candidate.
Yep.
Strike one to Brandon Nimmo. Again, you know, you're applying more pressure. Just by drawing a leadoff walk, you're Francisco Lindor. You don't need to do that.
You're
dunk on first.
Exactly.
Nimmo hangs back and rolls over to first. Freddie has it on the backhand. Underhand toss to Honeywell. Steps on the bag gently. Route number 2.
You know, sometimes we use the term non-competitive pitch. That was a non-competitive base running right there. You want to try and show off? Okay. You got caught.
And you want to do one shuffle move and see if he'll buy it or whatever, I get it, but that was just way too much.
Trying to be cute.
End up looking silly. Bases empty, 2 down. Here's Vientos. First pitch tapped off the very end of the bat, foul. Strike one.
Dodgers aren't through with this season, but think ahead, 25. Dodger memberships are on sale right now. Become a member, get access to all postseason games, preferred pricing, those opening day member events, a whole lot more. Check it out, Dodgers.com/membership.
In the air to center, Páez runs in and makes the catch. Ends up being a quick seventh inning for Brent Honeywell despite a leadoff walk, a pickoff attempt, and a ground ball to first, an early fly ball to center field. To go to the eighth inning, the Dodgers have 6 outs to get 5 or more runs.
AM 570.
LA's best sports talk.
The real home of the Dodgers.
It's time to escape the confines of the city and take in the comfort and ease of the San Ynez Valley. Stretch your legs, stretch your soul, maybe even stretch your luck at Shumash Casino Resort. Let the hustle and bustle of daily life disappear in your rearview mirror as you enjoy a scenic drive up the coast to your destination getaway. Once you're there, enjoy a spacious gaming floor, luxury hotel, and a beautiful patio restaurant. Welcome to freedom. Go to ShumashCasino.com.
Our favorite team is making their playoff push, and no better way to celebrate October baseball than with Hoppy Hot Dogs. To win in the playoffs, you have to be playing at your best, and Hoppy Hot Dogs are the best.
They use only top quality ingredients with premium quality beef for a great hot dog you can taste. And supporting our team is a time-honored tradition, and no one does it better than Angelino's. Hoppy is proud to be LA's local hot dog, delivering the best quality and taste for decades.
Visit HoppyBrand.com to find your Cravalicious hot dog.
Hoppy, local, original, great.
When it comes to personal injuries, Jacoby and Myers knocked it out of the park. And with a winning record of more than $2 billion in settlements, Jacoby and Myers is California's MVP. If you've been injured, don't settle for less than the firm voted the number one personal injury firm 5 years in a row. Get the justice you deserve with Jacoby and Myers. Call 1-800-5-MILLION for a free consultation today. And let the big league lawyers fight for you. Jacoby and Myers, the official law firm of the Los Angeles Dodgers.
Vroom, vroom.
From the Galpin Motors broadcast booth. Streaming right to your mobile device. LA Dodgers baseball continues on its official home.
For the Mets, including a pitching change, brought to you by Valvoline Instant Oil Change. Your 15-minute drive-through oil change at locations throughout Southern California. Carlos Mendoza bringing in the Mets closer, Edwin Diaz, and making defensive moves behind him. Harrison Bader off the bench now in center field. Tyrone Taylor picked over to left. So Brandon Nimmo out of the game, as is Mark Viento. Jose Iglesias will play third base. We are in the top of the eighth inning. The Dodgers have Andy Pahez leading off 3-for-3 with 2 home runs, followed by Shohei Ohtani and Mookie Betts. The Dodgers trail 11-6. Mo, it ain't over, but they're running out of outs.
Yeah, and the Dodgers, it's a frustrating night. They have not helped themselves, and they have handed opportunities to New York and the Mets. To their credit, they've taken advantage of it. Every time they took a strong hold on it.
Edwin Diaz closed out game 2, the Mets lone win. He starts his outing in game 5 with 96 on a fastball, called strike 1 on Andy Pahez in the inside corner. Here's the pitch. Pahez walks upstairs. Diaz pitched an inning in the third in game 2 at Dodger Stadium. Gave up just one hit. A walk that struck out 3 and no run. Here's the pitch. Pahez throws it off the plate away, but called strike 2. Pahez will take time, readjust his front left elbow guard. A warm-up swing now plants his right foot to the back edge of the right-handed batter's box. He's behind 1-2, leading off the top of the 8. And he takes one the other way, and it's slicing foul into the net on the right side. Top of the 8 brought to you by Morongo Casino Resort and Spa, the MVP for fun, food, and good time. Less than 90 minutes from wherever you are. Morongo, good time. 1-2 pitch. Ben Pahez back. 97 up and in. Square count 2-2. He's trying to chip away at the very least, make him throw a bunch of pitches. And Pahez chased one. That was assuredly ball 3. The Diaz with that trademark slider. Got a swing and a miss. They're out number 1 in the 8th. Down in the dirt. 10th strikeout for the Dodgers tonight. The day before, we'll say it again, it's been a role reversal tonight compared to the last 2 games here at City Field. Fastball up and away. Ball 1 to Shohei Ohtani. He struck out his last time up in the 5th, but before that, a pair of singles and a walk. A 1-0. Ohtani sets his swing. High fastball at 98. Called strike one. One pitch. Ohtani swings through. Strike two. 97 by him. Time granted for Shohei. Sellout crowd at Citi Field. 43,841. And like the last two nights, they stuck around to avoid innings. The team leads 11-6, trying to keep their season alive and send the series back to L.A. The 1-2. Strike three, swinging. High fastball at 99. Shohei down on strike for a second time. Two out. Well, it looks like the Dodgers are getting good Edwin Diaz in this championship series, Mo.
Well, and where Diaz has had a difficulty is with close games of recent times.
There's six strikes to Mookie Betts. 99 upstairs by 6 inches, but Bill Miller gave him strike one. Diaz working quickly. 0-1. Mookie checks up. That pitch in the same place called the ball, so go figure. 1-1. Mookie 2-for-3. A double, walk, and a solo homer. 1-1 pitch. Moves the bat on the shoulders again. It's a Yanks fastball at 97. 2 balls, 1 strike. Home run made it 10-6. 4 runs. Feels, I know it's only 1 run, but it feels more doable than 11-6. Diaz goes to a slider right in the heart of the plate. Taken by Betts for a second strike. It's 2-2. Diaz ready. And Mookie off the end of the bat. Beyond the glove of Diaz. The pickup at second by McNeil. And the throw over the first beat. Steps down the line. It's a 1-2-3 eighth inning for Edwin Diaz. He gets through the scariest part of the Dodger lineup. Getting Pines. Tonight anyway. Pines for Ohtani and Betts in order.
This is AM 570 LA Sports.
Hi, it's Hannah, and welcome to the Hannah Cast. Today, Piggy Bank's going to fuel our episode with questions about Otto Rewards. Yep, earn up to $7 in rewards at sign up. Uh-huh, and 5 cents on every gallon. Sounds pretty sensible, if you ask me. Oh, all the savings cost making you hungry? Here you go. Learn how to earn at ArcoRewards.com.
Offer valid until October 31st, 2024. By entering your phone number, you're going to receive a current automated informational marketing SMS and MMS messages for marathon. Other terms and conditions may apply to participating locations only.
Flex your baseball knowledge on Prize Picks, America's number one fantasy sports app. Super easy to play. Select two or more players, pick more or less on their stat projections, place your entry, whether it's strikeouts, RBIs, home runs, take your pick, more or less, and place your entry today, right now. Get $50 instantly when you play your first $5 lineup. Just download Prize Picks, the app, and use the code KLAC, that's KLAC, on Prize Picks to get $50 instantly after you play your first $5 lineup. Prize Picks, run your
The L.A. County Department of Mental Health congratulates the Dodgers and looks forward to another win and title. Remember, the L.A. County Department of Mental Health is always there for you and your loved ones by offering free emotional support, service referrals, and crisis counseling. Hope, recovery, and well-being are just a phone call away on the 24/7 helpline at 1-800-854-7771. That's 1-800-854-7771. Or visit the L.A. County Department of Mental Health at dmh.lacounty.gov.
Hey, it's Max Muncy.
The Giants player, Max Muncy.
This is LA Dodgers baseball. Listen to every game on the iHeartRadio app.
Inning at Citi Field. The New York Mets fighting to stay alive in the National League Championship Series and stiff arm the Dodgers celebration here in Queens. They lead the Dodgers 11-6. They're just 3 outs away. They have 3 outs here to get some insurance runs.
So this building, we talked about it really each the last 2 nights. The electricity has been turned off early in games. They're not tonight, and no one's leading for the 7th frame. Not until this one's over.
You can't shake the feeling of that first inning. Top of the first, second and third, nobody out. first pitch ground ball from Teoscar Hernandez, the shortstop. Shohei opted to stay at third instead of come home. But Dale, they get nobody home. And then Alonzo's three-run home run, and that's we're off and running. It's Alonzo leading off the eighth, taking a pitch from Honeywell.
I'd like to know what that conversation was with Gino Ebel and Shohei Ohtani in that first inning. Normally, you're going to be told, hey, the infield's playing back.
Yeah.
You're going to everything, get back to the pitcher or maybe a third baseman.
Alonzo waves at a strike, even count for Honeywell.
Okay. The ball was hit to the shortstop, and Ohtani, no effort to come home. He didn't have a good secondary lead either from third.
1-1 pitch. Alonzo swings, little flare. Shallow center field is trouble. It'll get down. C.K. Hernandez gave it a good look, but couldn't reel it in. So a blue base hit for Alonzo leading off the eighth inning.
Well, that's a good way to put a bat out of commission. He just broke a little blooper. He was jammed. And another leadoff hitter, yep, getting on base for New York tonight.
4-5 innings for Honeywell. And look, honestly, you have to tip your cap to Brent Honeywell at this point. He helped keep them in it in game two, and he's done his best here. This is his fifth inning of work in game five. First pitch to Winker, down and in, ball one.
There's a couple of good spots. I mean, you look at Dent, continues to swing the bat, home run and a double. He's walked off them. Ha has three hits, a couple of home runs. Other than that, it's been, well, very scarce for the Dodgers offensively.
Jesse Winker swings through a fastball at 93. One ball, one strike.
Never good when you leave eight runners on base through the first four innings. And that's exactly what happened, including leading the bases loaded in the fourth.
Jesse Winker has reached twice and scored all three times in four trips to the plate. 1-1. Off the plate, two balls and a strike. I just don't see at this point, given what we watched from J.D. Martinez the last two nights and then what we've seen from Winker when he's been in there, how you can make any of the decisions and have Winker as your
day. It's night and day.
It's not even close. One on, nobody out, bottom eight, 11-6 New York. Winker called for time. Winker had an RBI triple off Honeywell in the fourth after Alonzo was hit by a pitch. And then Winker leading off the sixth was hit by a pitch and came home to score on McNeil sack fly. Honeywell 2-1. Winker watches a second strike. Fastball at 92. Dodger right-hander out of the stretch. 2-2 pitch fouled away. Alonzo on first. No outs in the eighth. Honeywell will try again. Another 2-2. Just missed outside with a screwball, full count. Manuel peels over his left shoulder at Alonzo. Delivers a 3-2 to Winker. He swings and drives one to right field. It will hit off the top of the wall. Alonzo hustling for third. It's going to be a long single for Jesse Winker. That was narrowly a two-run home run, but it was certainly loud contact for Winker against Honeywell.
And it continues for the Mets. They're swinging the bat like they've been handed it to see the papers. So, hey, look, second pitch is going to be a curveball. Third pitch is going to be a fastball. They had not been fooled. I mean, the three innings that Flaherty was in there, he mentioned it earlier, there were only two swings and misses against Flaherty.
First and third, no out. So whatever hope you had for a Dodgers ninth inning comeback is dwindling. And at the corners, no out. Pinch runner for Jesse Winker. Luis Angel Acuña. Starling Marte takes strike one.
Starling Marte shooting for a record.
Four
doubles in one postseason game.
And three.
Kickoff attempt unsuccessful at first. How rare is it for four doubles in a postseason game? Wayne Mazzola going back. Chicago White Sox. Frank Isbell, 1906.
Love you, Dwayne. The 0-1 from Honeywell. Marte checks his swing on a pitch blown away.
It must be put out there that the two of you
who grew up here,
who grew up as White Sox fans.
That's right.
Didn't have to be the case this year.
No, we're dumb
along with
stupid,
a few thousand other people.
1-1, Acuna running. Marte swinging, base hit in the center field. Alonso comes from the score. Acuna goes to third. RBI single, Starling Marte. 12-6 New York. Still nobody out.
And tonight, the Mets have absolutely handled the Dodgers, not only their lunch, they handed them dinner, too.
And again, I'm gonna make this point again, Mo. It's one thing to lose this game, but the way that the Dodgers are losing this game, you have given New York so much belief, so much energy,
yep,
and so much life. It is just the absolute, worst-case scenario is all subjective.
Well, the way that they have played, in particular, the way that they have hit. They haven't pitched particularly, well, not outstanding, but they have allowed the Mets to get hope.
Yep.
Hope that they can do it. Hope that they've been able to come back. And it gives them life. It gives them energy. It's going to be a different flight for New York. You start to look at the first two games of this series, and you figure that the Mets would not have a plane even headed west to complete the series in Los Angeles. Well, that's going to happen now.
At the corner, still no out. 12-6 Mets. Tyrone Taylor, the Torrance native, swings and misses strike one.
Anthony Bonda gets up in the bullpen against the throw with a kind of a leisurely pace.
This will be the 65th hit from Brent Honeywell. Roman's work out of the bullpen. And what was kind of a clunker early. Eight runs given up by Jack Flaherty. All one to Taylor, even to count. Traveling tonight, off day tomorrow. In the game at Dodger Stadium, barring a miraculous ninth inning for the Dodgers. Two ball misses inside from Honeywell, 2-1. One pitch. Taylor swings. Ground ball back to Honeywell. Looks the runner to third. Goes to second for one. There's a turn for two. What a play by Brent Honeywell. It was a tapper from Taylor right back to Honeywell, who looked Acuna back to third base. Spun around, went to second for one, and the Dodgers turn two.
Nicely done and very thoughtfully done. Looking the runner back at third base to begin with.
Pause 10 seconds for station ID on the Dodgers Audio Network.
The NL West. You're the top seed in the National League.
The best record in baseball.
LA Dodgers October Baseball Edition.
KLAC, KYSR HD2, Los Angeles.
Dodgers making a pitching change. Brent Honeywell is out of the game. Anthony Bonda is coming in with the Mets up 12-6. We'll be right back on the Dodgers Audio Network.
Hey, it's David Bassay. Colder temps are coming. Now is the time to make sure your home is primed for the season with heating products by Navien. We know Navien tankless water heaters gives us endless hot water and big savings. Navien also makes high-efficiency products that deliver comfort in the form of heat to every corner of your home. Now Navien is taking comfort to the next level by introducing a hydro furnace that provides even high-efficiency forced air heat powered by the same proven technology as their water heating products. Visit NavienInc.com/Dodgers.
Medicare beneficiaries need help choosing the right health plan during this year's AEP? Let PIH Health be your guide to all things enrollment. Don't miss your chance to join our network in 2025. Visit PIHHealth.org/Medicare or call 888-365-4450. That's 888-365-4450. 888-365-4450. PIH Health, your health and wellness partner.
In the history of Dodger Stadium, there have been 19 total rainouts. Hi, I'm Dave Roberts, and last year's rain was one for the books, and it was L.A. County's best for capturing that rain. Over 200 billion gallons of storm water was captured, enough for 5 million people, or enough water to cover attendance at 89 sold-out home games. L.A. County was hard to ensure a safe, clean, reliable water future. Find out more at waterforla.com.
I, at first blush, Rick Monday, I don't understand that. Well, Anthony Fonda was up earlier when Jack Flaherty was getting hit around, and then he sat down. And so now, in the bottom of the eighth inning, with the Dodgers trailing by six, they're going to Fonda with two outs and a runner on third?
The only explanation that I can come up with is the fact that Fonda, you know, last pitched on Monday.
He's getting some light work. Jeff McNeil batting, Acuna on third. Here's the pitch from Fonda. McNeil swings through, strike one, and then he kind of, like he might have tweaked something. He's walking gingerly around the batter's box. The Dodgers, to this point, as a pitching staff, Mo, don't have a single strikeout.
Well, the miss, all night long, very few swings and misses.
Bonner ready is 0-1. McNeil swings a rocket right back over the head of Bonner, fielded by Edmund at short. He throws across. Good pick by Freeman at first base. So Bonner ultimately only throws two pitches and gets the last out of the eighth inning. The Dodgers down to their final three outs, trailing by six in game five.
Download the iHeartRadio app and listen to AM 570 LA Sports.
Anywhere, anytime.
Anywhere in the world.
In the history of Dodger Stadium, there have been 19 total rainouts. Hi, I'm Dave Roberts, and last year's rain was one for the books, and it was L.A. County's best for capturing that rain. Over 200 billion gallons of storm water was captured, enough for 5 million people, or enough water to cover attendance at 89 sold-out home games. L.A. County was hard to ensure a safe, clean, reliable water future. Find out more at waterforla.com.
Take me out to Morongo, where I can watch all the games. With thousands of slots there and blackjack, with big screen TVs from the front to the back. Yes, the dining there is outstanding. Sideline Sports Bar is simply grand. We were both hit, yes, once again, best casino of the Southland.
Morongo, good times.
Hey, this is Adrian Gonzalez. Dennis Jewelers is a proud sponsor of the Trip Around the Diamond and your family jeweler since 1948. Mention Home Run at any of their stores to receive a free team bracelet and $50 off any purchase of $99 or more. And don't forget, everyone is approved for credit at Daniel. So visit DanielsJewelers.com now to find the nearest store. Own the dream with Daniel Jewelers.
Every day, on air or on the app, L.A. Dodgers baseball lives right here on its exclusive home.
Kids, no more stressing over your old vehicle. Donate it today, get it picked up tomorrow. Go to carsforkids.org, cars with a K. Dodgers nearly locked up just the third game in the last 6 years. Team has zero strikeouts in a postseason game. Talk about the staff. The Mets haven't struck out once tonight. So here we are on the top of the ninth inning. New York up on the Dodgers 12-6. Edwin Diaz is going to be back down on the mound for New York. I guess it's similar. Different and similar, Mo, for Mendoza as it was for Dave Robinson, the Dodgers, with Fonda, is, you know, getting him some work. Diaz hasn't pitched since game two. He's
have to look at the Dodgers, too. The last time the Dodgers in postseason did not have a single strikeout in the ballgame. Go back to 1974, the National Championship Series, Game 2 in Pittsburgh against the Pirates.
Teoscar Hernandez leading off. Pitch and Diaz. It is off the plate, called strike one.
Let me make an observation here.
What's the observation?
I've not been blown away by the interpretation of the strike zone so far in this series or in the series against the Padres.
Teoscar Hernandez in the air right field, shallow right, playable for Marte, about 15 feet inside the line. He records the out. Teoscar Hernandez, 0 for 4 tonight, and now in the series, 0 for 18. That is one of the more unbelievable stats of this championship series, is that Teoscar Hernandez has got a single hit in five games.
And has not hit the ball hard.
You're right. Up and away, ball one to Freddie Freeman. Base is empty, one down, top of the ninth inning. Two outs to get six runs.
There will be more games at Dodger Stadium. Don't get left out. Dodgers.com/postseason for tickets.
High fastball, 2-0.
Well,
guaranteed two more home games at least in this postseason. Freddie Freeman swings at the 2-0. Fly ball, shallow center. Two gone.
The Mets will have a plane headed west.
Maybe two. Tommy Edman, the batter. Last out for the Dodgers here in Game 5. They trail 12-6. Edman is 1-for-4. And the base hit back in the third inning. Diaz, different strike one. Slider at 91, right down the middle. I think the Dodgers are flying home tonight. As Edmund grounds the ball to second, fielded by McNeil, who throws wildly off the facing of the Met dugout. So Edmund will reach on an infield single. Well fielded by McNeil, like getting to it on his backhand, running to his right. But he was fortunate that ball didn't go into the dugout and give Edmund an extra 90 feet. Anyway, what the point was, the New Dodgers are going home. The only question would be is, how happy was the plane, and how much would it smell like champagne? Now, as we sit here right now, it's not going to be a happy plane. And it's not going to smell like champagne. DK swings at the first pitch. Fly ball, right field. Marte knows it. Mets fans know it. There will be a Game 6 in the National League Championship Series. The New York Mets force the flight back to L.A. These two teams will play again on Sunday. There's no way around it, Rick Monday. It was an absolute, another clunker in this championship series. There hasn't been a single close game yet. And this was an egg that was shocking to see the Dodgers lay.
Yep, and for Zach Flaherty, 8 runs allowed. And that ties the Dodger postseason record. Clayton Kershaw, 2014, National League Division Series, Game 1 against the Cardinals and Chad Billingsley. Go back to 2008, Championship Series, Game 2 at Philadelphia against the Phillies. But if you're looking at the Mets, looking for a spark, and down to the hopes, it was either win tonight or they go home. Well, they're going to be headed west. But for the Mets to not have a strikeout the entire game, and the way that they swung the bat tonight, the Dodgers made either very poor pitches or the Mets knew what was coming. And I doubt if it was the latter part. The Dodgers simply did not pitch well at all. They missed golden opportunities. The busters came open. But when you score the runs that they were able to score, you put six on the board, and you don't feel that you're really in the game at any particular point, it's a long, long night.
Really could be a more disappointing night for the Dodgers. We'll take a break on the Dodgers Audio Network, come back, put a bow on the curve.
The exclusive home of the Dodgers.
AM 570, LA Sports.
For over 35 years, Zenki has been perfecting the art of handcrafted sushi. Each roll is made fresh daily with precision, passion, and a tradition you can take. And now for a limited time, you can visit your nearest Ralph supermarket and get $1 off some of our favorites. The Mango Crunchy Dragon Roll, the Yuzu Teriyaki Tuna Roll, and the Spicy Tuna Roll. This offer applies only while the boys in blue are in the playoffs and is available only at Ralph's location. Grab Zenki handcrafted sushi and enjoy exceptional flavor in every bite.
Freddie Freeman here. When it comes to our kids' health, you don't settle for second best. Meet Dr. Kellen from California's number one Osprey Orthopedic Center at Children's Hospital of Los Angeles.
I'm Dr. Kellen, a sports medicine specialist proud to work at the top-ranked orthopedic program on the West Coast and number two in the U.S. Did you know we have experts across the greater Los Angeles area with locations in Valencia, Arcadia, Tarzana, and South Bay? Visit chla.org/ortho to find the best pediatric care close to home.
Matt Money Smith here for Galpin Ford. Talk about championship level organization. You know a little something about that, right? Galpin exclusives right now. 10-year, 100,000-mile limited powertrain warranty on almost every used vehicle and every new Ford. And this is one of the largest inventories of Fords anywhere on earth. You want an EV, you're going to get a wall box home charging station with the purchase or lease of any new electric vehicle. On top of that, you know Mike Schwartz, the general manager. Ask for him by name. It's 1-800-GO-GALPIN off the 405 at Roscoe or check out GalpinFord.com.
This is the home of L.A. Dodgers baseball.
What a night!
Hear the blue all season long right here.
The home of the Dodgers.
The Mets keep their season alive and handle the Dodgers in Game 5. 12 runs on 14 hits. They lead 8 on. The Dodgers, 6 runs, 9 hits, 9 left on base. Ryan Stanek gets the win. Jack Flaherty, who gave up 8 of the 12 runs, takes the loss. And so now Game 6 on Sunday. But again, 12 runs, 14 hits, and who knows how much optimism, belief, hope, positivity the Dodgers gave the Mets here tonight. And that remains to be seen.
Well, you can put all kinds of plants on this, but the facts are what the facts are. Now it's a rejuvenated New York Mets team that will head west and take on the Dodgers on Sunday. And those are going to be handed to the ballpark. We cannot emphasize enough to get there early. I mean early. And in New York tonight, for example, Dodgers were 1-for-7 with runners in scoring position results, and they missed golden opportunities. They missed up 9 runners on base. They left 8 on in the first 4 innings, including bases loaded in the fourth inning. But the New York Mets tonight had 19 at-bats with runners in scoring position. And that is rather significant because in this series, they'd only had 29 hit such advance in the first 4 games. So it was a landslide as far as the Mets coming over on top of the Dodgers, and an extremely disappointing effort.
The Dodgers will fly home. They'll get back to the West Coast late on this Friday night. Rest up Saturday, back at it Sunday at home. But the Dodgers still lead this championship series 3-2. 1 win away still from a World Series berth. But there's just no other way around it. Tonight was just a massive, massive disappointment. That's going to do it for us from Citi Field. On Sunday, Game 6, NLCS, Dodger Stadium. You need to be there. You need to be there early, as Mo alluded to. Morongo Casino, Dodgers on deck. Kicks off our coverage at 4 p.m. First pitch slated for 5:08. A 5:08 start time on Sunday afternoon at Dodger Stadium. Tim Case has the Navi and Dodgers Clubhouse Show coming up next. So on behalf of the World Series champion, Rick Monday, our MVP, the producer and engineer, Dwayne McDonald, and the Southern Studio holding it down, Colin Yee, I'm Steve Nelson saying good night. Anything but a good night from New York.
What is tonight going to be played?
Well, that's entirely up to you and your spirit. Over here at Wild Turkey, we're opting for something that rings true and can reverberate for ages. A little 101. Wild Turkey 101 has been pleasing crowds for decades with its iconic, rich flavor. Crafted with generations of know-how and the finest ingredients. Wild Turkey. Trust your spirit.
Copyright 2024, Campari America. New York, New York. Never compromise. Drink responsibly.
Hey, baseball fans, David Van Zay here. We're in the hunt to win it all. And if you're in the hunt for a new outdoor living space, look no further than TimberTech Decking and Railing. TimberTech is made with up to 85% recycled materials and proprietary technology for a better deck and a better planet. TimberTech is so natural looking, it's hard to distinguish from real wood. No decking has more color, width, installation options, and top-rated fire resistance than TimberTech. It's everything wood should be. Get free samples, find a local contractor, and more. Or at TimberTech.com. That's TimberTech.com.
Hi, it's Taylor, and welcome to the Santa Class. Today, Piggy Bank's